Really fast section to the downhill, and you came basically flat, and then you have a braking, and then you have like flat minus over the crest. I had marked like stone inside, but maybe from the wall had come a very, very big rock. There was a massive rock on the absolutely on the line, and had so much speed that I couldn't avoid it. Otherwise, I would have been going off the road. So unfortunately, I hit it, and I had got the puncture, and I damaged something on the front suspension.
So with both Wags Fords in trouble this morning, it's left the Citroën boys out front on their own. And after a somewhat underwhelming start, set by his high standards, Sebastian Loeb has begun to build his speed.
It's a narrow section here. What the Loeb is right on the pace. Claims his first stage win in this new stage.
Spent a lot of time, haven't they, Jules, on this car, making sure that it works at altitude. So important on these stages in particular.
Did it. Mikko Hirvonen is taking and making the most of that as he can. His time is up, so is Loeb's. Obviously, Loeb finishing the stage already. Mikko charging towards the end here. Tell you what, he's going to be slower, but he still stays ahead. It's only now by 0.6 of a second.
Incredibly close then, indeed, at the front. But Jules, the man who has struggled this morning, Jari Matti-Latvala, what's going on here? What happened to that car? What are they doing here?
It broke the suspension in the stage when he hit that rock. This was on the road section afterwards. Petter's come along, finished the stage. He's trying to give some encouragement to Jari Matti, you know?
Which he's allowed to do, not allowed to help, but he
That's
can encourage.
It. And they actually utilised some of the tools out of the toolkit to fix that car. Not just a rally driver, you've got to be a mechanic as well nowadays.
So Latvala's delay has seen him fall all the way down to 7th, just ahead of his teammate Solberg, who's fought his way up to 8th place after his own problems this morning. Osberg is the leading forward in 3rd, and it's a Citroën 1-2 up the front with Hirvonen just having the edge on low. So blue skies above the Citroën duo as the crews arrive back at the Lyon Polyforum Service Park.
It's been a good morning, very difficult morning, especially the last stage. It was extremely difficult, very technical and very slippy as well. So it definitely hasn't been easy morning, but a good start anyway.
Quite slow start. Don't have really the reason. It was really special. It was a quite some concrete on the road, a bit different from the gravel stages, and maybe I didn't have the right rhythm in that.
All smiles then at Citroën, but there's a busy service ahead for the Ford mechanics. Both Latvala and Solberg's cars looking rather battle-scarred after this morning in Mexico.
Jari hit a big rock, which broke the front suspension. He believes it wasn't there on the recce, so don't really know how it's happened. But yeah, we've come into here, I don't know, in 8th from 9th position. So hopefully they can pull back to, I think, you know, they can quite easily get back to 3rd or 4th, but long way to go.
Well, an optimistic sounding Malcolm Wilson. We're into stage 6 and the temperature is now nearing 30 degrees Celsius. The crews are soon leaving the sanctuary of service. Next up, the second pass through El Cubaletti. And with the roads all swept clear at the top layer of loose gravel, there's an open playing field for all. Jules Oytanak, steady as he goes for Oyt.
That's it, it's been a good solid run for him. But here is Jari Matti-Latvala again. The fight back begins.
Malcolm Wilson saying maybe as high as 3rd or 4th of these two. It's going to take some driving for them.
He's going to have to be at his ultimate best and ultimate bravery. That's if that is a chance, is an option.
And we've seen that before from Latvala. Drops some time and then goes flat out. He can set some stunning times on this surface.
I tell you what, this is an aggressive drive. He is absolutely on it. Look at the commitment in here.
He's got nothing to lose now, really. He needs points here after the disaster in Monte.
Malcolm Wilson will say that. He's absolutely flying in here.
There's no parapets on those little bridges there. Very close indeed.
It's just a full-on attack, and here's the man he's trying to chase down.
Absolutely, and you know, Sebastian Loeb, what can we say? He is absolutely flying. He's had a trouble-free day so far.
I see, he's actually getting a split into his car from his teammate, Mikko Hirvonen, until the team noticed how quick Latvala was going, and they switched it to give him a warning.
Are they concerned about Latvala?
I think so. Well, I think they are.
Back onto these cobbles. This looks brand new. That's very strange. Who's that on the left?
That's Terry Neuville off the road. That was obviously Tanak gaining a place from that. And Neuville off the road. The wheel was missing.
What happened to
him? He's hit one of these curves, a little bit like Petter did when he got his puncture.
Yeah, and this obviously so, so different from the majority of the kilometres and stages here. It just takes a little bit of getting into, Jules, on these sections of cobbles.
Well, that's it, and the drivers are saying, to be fair, it's so important here with the altitude and how wide the roads are, you've got to drive these like a tarmac driver, not a gravel driver. Use every inch of the road and be super smooth.
Well, who's the best tarmac driver out there, Julian?
This man, Mr.
Absolutely,
Lowe.
Absolutely, absolutely. And, well, we know how well he goes on these stages. Five wins, as we've already said, looking to make it six here on these stages, and certainly looking good.
That's a big fight between the pair, and Lowe takes the lead.
Yeah, he takes the lead, but Jari Matti makes incredible time.
But you always knew that with him.
Yeah, but you know, he's fast and it's still a long way to go, so I need to speed it up a little bit, but no problems anyway, so everything okay.
Yeah, a long way to go, as Nico Hartman said. He slips to second, his deficit below, standing at 2.2 seconds after stage six, while Mads Osberg, still the leading four, but he's a long way adrift in third. Latvala, he's already made up two places to sixth. Well, it's into stage 7 and 8, and it's great to see Nasser Al Attiyah making his debut in a World Rally Car on gravel. We saw him in Sweden, his first time on gravel.
Tell you what, he's getting the hang of it looking at him through there. It's great to see Nasser, obviously won the Dakar last year, and he's got a full programme in his camp bar in Finland when he's competing in the Olympics. I tell you what, this man can do everything, can't he?
He's so excited to see Nasser in a World Rally Car after so long, but it's equally as exciting to see Chris Atkinson back in a World Rally Car and beginning to find his feet.
Yeah, last time he drove a World Rally Car properly, there was all sorts of active dips and paddle shifts and everything. I'll tell you what, he's doing really, really well so far.
A lot of pressure on him this weekend. He really wants to show what he's capable of.
Chris, quickest time so far. I know you're going to say the same as all the boys are coming behind, but you're getting more and more into this car now.
Yeah, I think we made a step on that stage. I've been too neat on the entry and then too wide on the exits, and I tried to throw it a bit more. We're going to have to change the setup a bit, but not every second corner I got right then. So we're heading the right direction.
Good to see things. Getting Novikov, what a start to the year he's had. Two fifth places, remarkably good here last year until he had problems.
Yeah, an engine problem last year. Well, a whole sump, I think, basically, dropping the oil out of it. But tell you what, he's had a couple of fifths already this year. It's a new Evgeny Novikov. And I tell you what, I like it.
Oh, I think it's great because we know how fast this young Russian is. We've always known that a bit of consistency and he'll set some great times. Doing a good job today.
Well, there's another man who's done a great job early on. Petter Solberg is obviously having to fight back. The balaclava lifted up really high there. She's just coming in through all the holes that are being created by the punctures.
How desperately disappointed must he feel though, Jules? Great start to the rally with the qualifying stage and stage one. Those punctures early on in the day though, difficult to find the motivation, or is he desperate for the points?
Desperate for the points, desperate to keep it going. And here's another man who's on a mission, a massive mission. Tell you what, Mikko Rantala, he must be on massive money to sit in that car.
Gok's good, I think Gok's.
Jari Matti Latvala with this problem, the problem that he had this morning with that broken suspension. He was looking so, so fast this morning, looking at anything quicker this afternoon.
Well, quickest again in stage 7. He moves up another two places. He's now 4.
Seconds now behind a podium. You wouldn't have thought that about 3 hours ago.
No, absolutely not. To try to attack, we want to get climb back to podium after the disappointment with hitting the rock. So, but it's been going now in the afternoon, a really good feeling.
Well, Jari Matti Latvala, his objective certainly is a podium, but holding that final podium place just now, young Mads Osberg, strong day for the Norwegian Jules.
Well, it is, and I tell you what, I was so disappointed after the qualifying and after the super special. Been a great run for Mads today.
Well, Sebastian Loeb and Mikko Hirvonen have had plenty of battles over the years, but never as teammates. They're battling today though.
Sebastian is absolutely on the limit, on the edge, pushing as hard as he can. Obviously Mikko is 1 year less experienced in this car. Loeb kind of developed it, tested it and drove it.
of this. Do you know, that looks like the section where Osberg had his problem earlier on today. We're pretty lucky for Osberg because that just showed how difficult these stages can be.
That's it. Despite Mikko only being third rally in this car, there's so little between these two now. It's brilliant.
So there's just 11 seconds between first and second place after the three super specials that ended the first leg. Osberg ends his terrific opening day in third, but the Works 4 drivers will be on a mission tomorrow. Latvala and Solberg will begin the second leg in fourth and sixth, respectively. So Hovland and Loeb are locked in their first serious fight as teammates, and Latvala is building up an inspired fight back. Lots to keep us entertained on the second day of Rally Guanajuato, Mexico. Make sure you join us again tomorrow for the day two highlights. For now though, from Leon, it's goodbye.